International experts have spoken highly of China's accelerating green transformation, saying China's solid green development contributes to improving global climate governance amid global polycrisis.
China now is actually in a position in its development wherein it is now willing and able and keen to play a greater leadership role in the global community, altering public goods, making a peace for global development initiative, and also making calls for investing in high quality Belt and Road initiative, which may help finance, you know, more green and renewable energy projects in the world. And so this may contribute in mitigating climate change. The lessons, the experience, and the resources that China can put to bear and share to the world will benefit a lot of developing countries.
We believe that China will have a big say in how we move forward, let's put it this way, BCG economy agenda. And the cooperation that we have received, the support that we have received from China throughout our process, it only shows that China is more than ready to be a big part of the process. So China can lead certainly by making example to the rest of the region, and I think this is what you are doing right now. You are leading the way in the, for instance, EV vehicle market in this region. I think that is a strong statement from China that we are serious about reducing carbon dioxide from our system.
China's ambitious target to green energy is geared towards increasing the effort for restoring forest ecosystems and biodiversity, restoring the forest cover, the national agenda of China to ensure that more pledges, more commitments toward renewable energy is being achieved by 2030 in a move actually to meet the global goals of sustainable development goals. So in terms of conservation, in terms of wetlands, to restore the wetland cover, China is doing a lot.